Bible School Church. Amen. We're coming to you with the subject and the theme today of the power of prayer. And we're going to start with Father Noah, a man of God. Amen. All the way down to Yeshua and his quotations of Noah's prayer and his life. We bless the Lord. You got to live some kind of life. When you find yourself in prayer, prayer is going to change your life anyway. Amen. The man called Noah, he had no doubt in what he had heard from the Most High, what he had heard from the angels. And he got to work. And while everybody mocked and jeered him, as he continued to pray and he continued to praise God. Amen. And the Bible said that Noah praised God and sang and danced in front of God until God actually laughed. Amen. A praying man, like the man named Moses, like the man named Samuel, like the man named Elijah, like the man named Daniel, and of course Christ Jesus Yeshua, the anointed one. We're not going to forget all the apostles, amen, and friends of Jesus Christ also, amen. Christ called the last generation, but it was Father Noah that called the first generation. We bless the Lord. He came with seven laws called the Noachide laws, and that brought Shimshah to the clan at that time. They're overlooked by many believers today, but Noah preached to the first generation and prayed. Amen. God is a God that changes not, my friends. In those days, Noah told people then about the worshipping of idols, the cursing of the Almighty God, murder, adultery, and sexual immorality, and theft, eating flesh from a living animal. He also told them to establish courts and justice and ban animal cruelty. Amen. The Lord changes not. All these are covered by Moses' law that he received at Mount Sinai, endorsed by Yeshua, Jesus, HaMashiach, the Anointed One. Amen. These laws are acknowledged by a few and abandoned by many. However, the good news is that the returnees, from breaking these commandments, they are growing in grace. They are growing in prayer, and they are growing in the word of the pages of the book. We bless the Lord. The children of Noah, they please the Most High by keeping these commandments. Jesus Yeshua referenced Noah and noted in the spiritual realm was Noah. The days of water he's referred to when the Father opened up the house of water and wept the tears. Amen. His watery eyes saw none but water. He thought about nothing but water and more water. And the earth was flooded. Amen. It's not like Noah never warned. It's not like Noah never prayed. It's not like Noah never cared. I said he warned. I said he prayed. He cared. And he preached. And he built the ark with the help of the angels. Amen. With the finishing touches. And the scripture of the flood is found in the word. Father Noah's prayers went up to the golden altar before the throne. Cited in Revelation chapter 8 and verse 3. Chapter 8 and verse 4. Talking about prayer enjoined. We bless the Lord. Exodus 15 and 24 said the people murmured against Moses, saying, "What shall we drink?" All the people murmured at Noah, mocked and jeered him, and they said, "What shall we drink and what shall we eat?" Amen. They hadn't heard that man shall not live by bread alone, but by any word that proceedeth from the mouth of God. Yeshua warned it will be like that when he returns, amen, also. I said the God Almighty changes now. Ezra 8, verse 23 says, after fasting and beseeching God, he was entreated of us. Amen. Feast of Weeks, saints, is halfway through the halfway mark. We're rolling on to glory. Amen. With Father Noah. Amen. Whose prayers were not refused as they were in the divine will of the Father. We bless the Lord. Let's not fuss about what position one should be in for a prayer to be accepted. These little trivial things, blocking people out of the kingdom of God, straining on a gnat. Amen, while they're swallowing a camel. We bless the Lord. Daniel 6 and 10 said that Daniel kneeled 3 times in prayer. Deuteronomy 9 and 25, Moses fell down prostrate. Amen, for 40 days. Amen, 1 Samuel 15 and 11 said Samuel cried out to the Lord. We bless the Lord. And then we have Mark 6 and 46. Yeshua, he went to the mountain. He went there to pray, saints. 1 Kings 8, 22 to 53 and 22, a key point, where Solomon stood before the altar of the Lord in the presence of all the congregation and spread forth his hands towards the heaven and prayed. So you can kneel, you can prostrate, or you can be in procumbents. But make sure you cry out according to Isaiah 58 verse 1 aloud. Amen, and acknowledge your sin. Or you can stand. Amen. Because those outside, amen, those who don't believe, those who are locked out the ark for unbelief, they're in opposed to the Lord. They're in opposed to his way. They're in opposed to his truth. They're in opposed to life. And they're opposed to Christ himself, known as the Antichrist. Amen. Noah laid a foundation, a first etch to the laws and the commandments, to be carried all the way to Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. Yeshua HaMashiach cried as he carried the Torah under his arm, in his satchel, in his hands. He never carried the New Testament, saints. He is the New Testament. We bless the Lord. So he couldn't carry the book while he still lived. Amen. In the testari, he would take his demise, amen, of the testari, for the last testament to be written and empowered. You can't claim death policy while he should live. So Yeshua quoted Noah because he carried the books. He carried all the books. He carried everybody's books. Amen. But his book didn't come, or books about him didn't come, until after his demise. We bless the Lord and his resurrection. And yet the call of Noah has rung throughout the generations past until this day. And still we are in denial of what Christ warned is coming. Matthew 24 and Matthew 25, the chapters. Not just persecution, not just tribulation, saints, but a time of harvest. A time of peace, a time of hearing, a time of fellowship, a time of rest, a time of rejoicing, and a time of praising. No one's talking about that. Everybody's endorsing doom and gloom and hellfire, all right? Amen. But there's going to be a time of honor, and a time of commendation, a time of promotion, a time of relief, and a time of safety, a time of contentment, a time of the blessed assurance that Jesus is yours. A time when 1 Kings 9 and 3 ignites in your life as a reality, where it says, I have heard thy prayers and thy supplication that thou was made before me. The apostle said, pray without ceasing. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 17, we bless the Lord. 1 Chronicles 16 and 11 said, and seek the Lord. Seek him and his strength and his face. And do this when? Continually. God changes not, saints. Remember when you pray, be patient and wait. 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 We wait at least 90 days for most things here on earth. But every time we approach the Father, we want an instant coffee. Right now, right now, right now, right now. Sometimes the Father moves right away. But sometimes, saints, we gotta wait. Psalm 27, the last verse says, wait, amen. All true prayers are heard by the Most High. Job 34 and 28, Psalms 4 and 3, Proverbs 15 and 29, Micah 7 and 7, and Zechariah 10 and 6. Some famous prayers, like the prayers of Daniel in Daniel 9 and 4, the prayers of Habakkuk 3 and 1, the Lord's Prayer, Matthew 6 and 9, and Paul's prayer for the Ephesians, Ephesians 3 and verse 14, the prayer of Stephen in Acts 7 and verse 60, Yeshua, Amashiach on the cross, Luke 23 verse 34, Hezekiah when he was sick, we bless the Lord, Isaiah 38, verse 2 and 3, Elijah at Carmel, 1 Kings 18, and 36, and the prayer of King Solomon himself in the New Testament. Jesus spoke about Solomon being the wisest man that ever lived, a man that ever was. We bless the Lord, and there was none arrayed like him. But he was a praying man as well. Now his daddy, King David, was the master of the prayer book itself, amen, the book of Psalms. And so it was in the beginning, amen. His throne shall be established in the last days. So it shall it be in the end. Revelation 1, 4 and 7 is a prayer of anticipation of the second coming of Yeshua HaMashiach. We'll also find in Revelation 2, 7 and 8. 8 verse 12, 17 verse 18, 2, 6 and verse 29, 3, 5 to 7. Prayers for the overcomers. Prayer for the Lamb, amen, or prayers to the Lamb. Revelation 5, verse 8. To 14, a prayer for the persecution and the persecuted, Revelation 6, verse 9 to 11, a praise at the end of the harvest, Revelation 7, verse 9 to 17, a prayer in the expectation of the future reign of Yeshua, Revelation 11, verse 15 to 18, a prayer asking Yeshua to come, Revelation 12, 17 and 20. Ephesians 1, 17 and 18 holds a prayer for increased understanding. A lot of us need that, a lot. Understanding of what? That the Holy Spirit will come and will guide thee into all truth. We bless the Lord, St. John 16 and 13. You'll find that right there. Now, during prayer, we have three elements that get to work. Praise, pardon and petition. We bless the Lord. Look them up. Then these unlock some things as well. They unlock gratitude. They unlock thanks. They unlock confession, humility, supplication, your requests, and your benediction. We praise the Lord. There are five types of prayer. Amen. Prayers of adoration, confession, thanks, supplication, an obligatory prayer. Amen. Today, whatever prayer that belongs to you, forget not, number one, to abide in Christ in the vine, in your prayer. Number two, to pray in faith while you're in your prayer. Number three, to stand on God's word while you're in your prayer. Number four, to pray in the spirit while you're in your prayer. Number five, to persevere in your prayer while you're in your prayer. And six, flow in God's love while you're in the prayer. Pray different ways if you can. The word strengthens your authority in prayer when you're in the courts of the Lord, amen. So we put out the word because in the beginning was the word. And the word was with God. And the word is God. Amen. As we continue to worship God in Jesus' name. Draw your attention to Abraham, who was 99 years old when he was circumcised. In Genesis 17 and verse 14, a lot of prayer took it right there. Sarah was renamed Sarah by Abraham upon what God had told him to do in Genesis 17 and verse 15. Communication with the Father is prayer. At 100 years old, as a result of prayer, Sarah did deliver their child. Amen. Amen. Genesis 17 and 17 got the whole story. Abraham makes a parental prayer for his son Ishmael. Amen. In Genesis 17 verse 18. Oh, that Ishmael might live before thee. But the father replied, with Isaac I will establish my covenant. Amen. Chapter 17 and 19. We bless the Lord. It's clear. Father declares in Joel 2 and Acts 2 that he will pour out his spirit on male and female, bonds and maidservants. All will prophesy, young and old men will have dreams and they will have visions. Now, without a vision, the people perish. We bless the Lord. You can bring all the rebuke you want, but where's your vision? Amen. We need a vision to follow around here. Amen. It's here. And it's upon us. And it's fulfilling right before our very eyes. Jesus is coming too. The angels ministered to Hagar. Genesis 16 verse 11. And the angel of the Lord said to her after prayer, "Behold, thou art with child, a son you shall call him Ishmael. Because the Lord has heard thy affliction." Hagar had a relationship, we bless the Lord. Got news of a son and what to call him. Conversation with the Most High, we call that what? We call that prayer. Jesus is coming soon. Amen. Mary got news of a son by Gabriel, the chief angel, the archangel of the Lord. Said, "Behold, thou shalt have a child. You shall call him Jesus." Mary got word from God of a child. She got word of what to name him. I said, Jesus is coming soon, saints. Hagar got instruction from the Most High God in Genesis 16 and 9. The angel brought the word. He said, "Return to thy mistress and submit thyself under her hand." Genesis 16 and 9, amen. If God didn't talk to women, what was he doing talking to Hagar? Amen. We bless the Lord. The Lord sorted the dispute between the jealous women. God said to Abraham, "He that comes from your own bowels shall be thine heir." The father asks again, Genesis 18 and 14, "Is there anything too hard for me?" Genesis 31 and 42, "We serve the God who said, I have seen thine affliction and thy labors of thine hand, and I rebuke thine oppressions." Jacob said, "Death to whosoever has stolen Laban's gods," not knowing that it was his own wife, Rachel, that had stolen it. That's why Jesus said, "Judge not." You're going to find that in Genesis 35 and 19. We ought not to judge without full investigations according to the commandments of the Most High God, who's got the whole world in his hands. We need five witnesses, eyewitnesses in agreement, amen, according to the commandments of the Most High God, who's got the whole world in his hands. Even the man found guilty and sentenced, and he's innocent, he can find favor in prison itself. Look at Genesis 39, 20 to 23. The Lord was with Joseph. The Lord showed him mercy, gave him favor in front of the prison keeper. The prison keeper then promoted him to be over the other prisoners. Joseph, in bonds and chains, prospered in the hands of the Lord. Amen. Much prayer, much prayer, much prayer. Remember Exodus 14 and 14, "The Lord shall fight for you. And if you just hold your peace." We bless the Lord. You can't be running your mouth and expect God to fight for you. He don't work like that. Our God is the God that is involved in fighting all our battles and winning all our wars. Why we hold our peace, Exodus 14 and 14. Job 2 and Acts 2. God releases his own spirit, not the spirit of mankind, and he releases it upon all, men and women, bond and free, handmaidens alike, amen. Numbers 11 and 23, Moses said, "Let's see now if my word shall come to pass unto thee or not, amen. I have said it, let me see if it's not going to come to pass." We bless the Lord. Let's try these spirits that are coming forth, amen. For Jesus said, "Many shall come in my name and say that they're mine, and they're not." Numbers 11, 25 said that the Lord came down in a cloud, and he spoke, took of his spirit, and placed it on 70 other elders. The spirit of prophecy in 2021 has been unleashed. And the era of the false prophet is at hand. But Moses saw envy as well when he was prophesying. He asked the question, "Are you jealous for my sake?" Moses said, "I only wish that all God's people were prophets, and that God would put his spirit upon all." Joel 2 said that prayer was answered. Paul said in Acts 2, amen, Wait for it. Wait for it. It's coming. It's coming. He told Peter in the upper room, meet me there. I'll enjoy your power from an eye. Deuteronomy 4 and 39. Know therefore this day and consider it in thine heart, that the Lord is good. He is God in heaven above and upon the earth beneath. There is none else. 4 and 31. For the Lord thy God, he will not forsake thee, neither destroy thee, nor forget the covenant of thy fathers. Verse 32. Ask of days past before thee, since the day God created man on earth. Ask heaven from left to right, whether any other God has done the great things of the Almighty. Hashem. Verse 35. The Lord, he is God. There is none besides him. Wow. Deuteronomy 6 and 4. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. We bless the Lord. Shema. Verse 5. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy might. Verse 6. The words commanded this day shall be in your heart. Jesus said the same thing as well. We bless the Lord. Love the Lord thy God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength. And love your neighbor as yourself. Upon these two hang all the law and all the prophets. Sab, Shema. It's a command. Why? Well, Deuteronomy 7 and 6. For thou art my people, a holy people unto the Lord God. The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself, above all the people on the earth. Deuteronomy 7 and 9. Know therefore that the Lord thy God, he is God, the faithful God, which keeps covenant and mercy. Watch here, with them that love him. Amen. Deuteronomy 6 and 16. You shall not tempt the Lord your God. Jesus told the devil the same thing when he brought him up to the peak of the mountain. In the three temptations, we bless the Lord. Looking at our dear Jesus, out of his mind, asking him to bow down and worship him. And he'll give him all this right here. This world is everything else. Amen. Said, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. God you'll worship and him alone. Turn the stone to bread then. Man shall not live by bread alone, Satan. You're a liar. And the father of all lies. Cast yourself off the rock. Go ahead. It's written that the angels are gonna bear you up, lest you dash your little foot against the rock. Again, he said, tempt not the Lord thy God. Deuteronomy 11 and 27. It's a blessing, God said, if you obey the commandments which I command you this day. God bless you, saints. Ephesians 2, verse 13. Remember Christ. Made everybody come nigh to God by his blood. Verse 14, he is our peace. Ephesians 2 and 16, that he might reconcile both unto God in one body by the crucifixion, having slain the enmity thereby. Amen. Chapter 2 and 20, all built upon the foundation of the apostles and the prophets of old. Christ, Yeshua himself, being our chief cornerstone, we bless his holy name. The experience of a spiritual indwelling is the experience of a spiritual temple by the Holy Spirit sent from the Father. You become a habitation of God through the Spirit. Verse 22, a spiritual reconciliation by waves and waves of prayers heard by the Most High God, considered, answered, not turned away, but received by the Most High God. Let us pray for spiritual stewardship. Let us pray, as Jesus said, to escape the tribulation ahead. He said, you have not because you ask not. Let us pray sincere prayers, heartfelt prayers, have an access with the mediator in place, the one Yeshua. Amen. It's a universal call. It's not from Rome. It's from God's word in the books attributed to him. Let's get into the saving our faith, God in our spiritual hope, our spiritual heritage. Blessed be us in faith believing, making us believers. Amen. Remember your spiritual riches that no man can rob or moth destroy. A spiritual resurrection for those who passed away already. Flee the carnal mind and seek out the spiritual quickening. Amen. And the saving grace. And avoid spiritual poverty and destitution and spiritual death. But rather believe in your spiritual adoption. Nurse your spiritual relationship as children of God and not of the devil. Know that knowledge is withheld. It must come to plain sight, which is where we are right now. We are called. We are chosen with a divine purpose through prayer and fasting. It can all be known, saints. It can all be known today. Ephesians 3 and 14, Paul said, "For this cause I bow my knees to the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ." Paul prayed to the Father of Jesus Christ in order to overcome all his accusers. The Father blessed him and anointed him. Amen. With a generous spiritual love in spiritual abundance. This gave him spiritual power to stay the course. Let's stay the course, saints. Watch out for your spiritual progress. Keep spiritual darkness afar off, and your results will be righteousness and holiness with the Holy Ghost. Romans 8 and 14. For as many as are led by the Spirit, Brother Paul said, these are the sons of God. Verse 16. The Spirit bears witness of you. Verse 39. Let nothing separate you therefore from the love of God. Come to him. He will have divine passion and bring you, amen, to prayer and divine purpose. And then Romans 10 and 13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Faith comes by hearing, Romans 10 and 17, amen. Hearing by the word of God today. Romans 15 and 30, Paul asks for the saints to be united in intercession prayer to God for him. 1 Corinthians, amen. Paul in the will of God. 1:1. Greets you with peace from God. 1 Corinthians 1:3. Testifies of being saved by the power of God. 1 Corinthians 1:18. Brought the testimony of God. 2:5. And thanks to God. 1:6 and 1:4. We bless the Lord. Amen. 2:12 of the 1 Corinthians said, we have received the Spirit of God, so we know the things of God. Today, if you hear my voice, we bless the Lord. Amen. Harden not your heart towards prayer. We bless the Lord. Remember, Jeremiah took up a lamentation. Amen. A great prayer that broke his heart, and everybody that reads that book, we bless the Lord. He saw that God's people had suffered with many lovers. Amen. Lamentation 1 and 2, we bless the Lord. They were overtaken by these lovers in their straits and existed only in bitterness. Are we like her, watching our enemies prosper by the way of affliction from the Lord? Existing in bitterness instead of prayer? Children gone astray, we bless the Lord. Some on charges that they can't even spell. Totally innocent. Jerusalem, our happy home. Amen. The unrighteous mock our Sabbath days. We bless the Lord. Consider, amen. Bless the Lord. Our lamentations today, O God. And deliver us from our enemies and cause them not to rise. The prophet cried out. Amen. He said, the comforter that should come to relieve me and relieve my soul, he's far away. Amen. He prayed, but he found no comforter. His prayers were shut out. A cloud around the Most High blocking out the prayers. Amen. He cried unto God. He said, God, I'm in distress. My bowels are troubled. My enemies are glad that you've done this to me. But the children of Jacob didn't want to turn to the Father. We must return to him, saints. We're going to use prayer and find our way home. Then we're going to use prayer and climb the ladder of faith. And we're going to do it today. For these kinds cannot come about but by prayer. and but by fasting. When King David went to face Goliath, now that was a prayer. That was a real prayer. And he believed God, and God won. The victory went to Israel. When Samson had to face 1,000 men with a horn, just a jawbone in his hand, that was a prayer. When he had to push down the walls of Dagon for the last time, destroying all his enemy with him, that was a prayer. Jonah in the belly of the whale, I said that was a prayer. Amen. Solomon, when he prayed for us. Saints, don't let it all be in vain. Let us pray to God our Father in Jesus' name. And today God bless you. And today God keep you in the beauty of holiness. Our soon coming Yeshua HaMashiach. He's calling you to the Father today. Seek him out in prayer. And I promise you, you will not be disappointed. Shalom from the Remnant Bible School Church. Amen.